Take your time. Thank you. Gotta hold it. You gotta hold it, Mike. The mic is there. Hold the mic. Yeah, but you gotta hold the mic.
Praise the Lord. Good morning, everyone. This is a bittersweet occasion. We have come to celebrate the life of Deryck Murray. You know, and it's been a journey. But thank God we can say that we are celebrating his life this morning. So we're going to just start off by giving God thanks. I thank God for his life. I thank God for this moment that we are all gathered here this morning. The word of God said, in everything, in all things, give God thanks. So in the midst as we may be sad, in the midst that we may be grieving, we can still lift our hands and say, thank you, Lord. For he lived a good life. He lived a life that impacted so many. So at this time, we're going to begin our funeral service, and I'm going to call Chaplain Junie Chin to do the opening prayer for us.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Jesus, thank you, Jesus. We're here this morning to send soul of all goodness of him who is able to do exceedingly and abundantly of anything that we can ask or think. Let's bow our heads as we go in prayer. To those of us who are in the line, hopefully put it up. Let's not interrupt us. Appreciate it. Let us pray. Eternal God and our Father, this morning we come to you because you are God. There's absolutely nothing that is impossible with you. There's absolutely nothing that happens by happenings because you're in total control. And so this morning we come at your mercy seat, acknowledging that you are God and there's none like you. The occasion that we are here this morning in this family, well, not what we have wanted, but God, you know all things best. So this morning, God, we approach you one more time with a full understanding that you will never leave your children alone. You'll never leave us helpless. And so, God, we invoke your presence. Will you now begin to pour into your children? Bring peace and comfort like no other can. O Spirit of the living God, we know that you're acquainted with grief, and because you're acquainted with grief, we can come to you and we can say, Abba, Father, here we are. Will you come in and give us that peace like no other? Our God, you're the God who hears and you're the God who answers. We call you from a place of deep hurt this morning, knowing that you're touched with the feelings of our infirmities, feelings of sorrow. While we cannot understand what each other feel, deep down we do know that there is a feeling of sorrow. Father, we ask this morning that as the days ahead seem so dreary and worn, and will no longer be the same as yesterday, will you give confidence and comfort to those who are hurting this morning? Give those confidence this morning to a wife, to a sister, a brother, a niece and nephew, and the rest of the family and friends. God, this morning, you are the everlasting, forever God. And most importantly, you never fail your children. You have mastered drying tears. You give peace, oh God. Your embrace is always warm, and your touch will continue to give strength to the weary. This morning, your loving arms are always open to embrace your hurting children. Will you allow the family this morning to experience this love, even in this sorrow? Will you let sleep be peaceful, even when many questions are there to be answered? When they do arise, God, we ask in the name of Jesus that you'll complete the answer full well to their expectation, because you're God. Will you now, Father, wrap us, wrap this family, wrap your children in your warm and tender love. Cause them, oh God, to seek refuge in you this morning. As we go through this service, may you shine in the hearts of us, your children, and may we never left answering, oh God, those questions that we ask of you by ourselves, knowing that you're God and you answer according to your will. We ask that you take the service in full control this morning. Remember our pastor. Remember the moderator this morning. I pray your anointing upon her and upon, oh God, Sister Beverly. I pray, God, that they'll never be the same, even in death. Oh God, experiencing death is not like any other experience, but we are confident that you hold us into the cleft of the rock. Hear us this morning, we pray, in Jesus' name.
Praise the Lord. And we're going to do our congregational scripture this morning, Psalms 23. And if you don't mind, can you please stand? This was one of my brother's signature scripture. Each time I meet with him, we would say the scripture together when he was able to communicate. The last day, the last morning, the last night, this was the scripture we said together. Yeah, so let's say it together, Psalms 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over, and surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. And let the people say, amen. You may be seated. And we're going to sing our first congregational hymn, Great is Thy Faithfulness. So I'm going to need a little help. Where's my helper? Oh, come. It's also in the program. So we have two individuals who are going to help us here.
I'm the Holy Spirit.
Three, one.
Great is thy faithfulness. Great is my faithfulness.
No shadow
turning with thee. Thou changest not, my compassion lifted not. As thou hast been, thou forever will be. Great is thy faithfulness. Is thy faithfulness morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, I hand and Lord, I bear. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me.
So this time we're going to have some tributes, And I must guide you. I'm gonna say 2 minutes. We have to be out here on time. We're gonna call his children. His daughter Abia, please come. Akif, please come.
Good morning, everybody. Thank everybody for being here. Thank you all for everything, you know. It's a big day. You don't know what to say, but my dad would know what I would want to say. That's all. But,
but today, thank y'all. Thank you.
Thank you. Amen. Amen. And I must acknowledge this young lady. You know, my brother was very, very ill. You know, he had a lot of physical ailments. And she stood with him. She cared for him. You know, one time, you know, she was standing and I was there. The thing she did, I could not do it. He called her the construction worker. Because, you know, as many know, there was some issue with his stomach. And you had to be skilled to do what needed to be done with his stomach. So I bless God for her. So I thank God for her. Let's put our hands together for her. Coming to us now, he has one son in Trinidad, and we're moving quickly with time. Kurth, my brother-in-law, would just like to read this tribute from him.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning. Good morning.
Thank you all for coming out. What I'm about to read is a note, a tribute from Leslie, that is Deryck's other son, his son, Trinidad. All right, so he sent his portion. This one just to everyone that gathered to bid farewell to my dearly beloved father, I greet you in the wonderful name of God. Love, peace, and gratitude. A pleasant good day to all. I am unsure on where to even begin. First thing that I can say is that life is really challenging. Our relationship was an odd one indeed, but we understood each other on different levels as friends, as brothers, as doctor and patient, etc. But as a father, his reasoning was like no one. Your teachings was through actions with me. You showed me how it's done, and I got it done. I also adapted that method of teaching, and I'm proud to say it's a very productive way of life. Let's talk more action. A lot of your memories will live on in the hearts of mankind without a doubt. But for me, my most treasured memory of you is in the kitchen. Let me explain something to everyone here. When this legend cooking, especially in Trinidad, is the whole hill, John Street, that's where we used to live, John Street. It's the whole hill, John Street, passing for food and getting through. Music on, while he take a pull of God's green grass and giving thanks, saying, "Jack!" Even though you are physically gone in the flesh, when I look into the mirror, I see I am your reflection in many ways. Rest easy, Dad. I love you. Don't expect to see any of your children soon, because we all have our individual willpower as well as yours to carry on. We gotta trust and believe that God will work out whatever trials and challenges we may face in this life. But in doing that, we have to prepare ourselves for the path God chooses for us. God bless. Thank you.
Amen. 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 I remember one time I went to Trinidad, and my brother, when he lived there, he planted garden. I mean, he could have gone in that garden and prepared any meal. He didn't need meat, whether it's the cut the green bananas or dig the cassava or pick some okras, you know. He put together a meal. And for that, so many people can say that he's touched their lives with that. Also coming to us, Mr. Hassan. My brother also had some bonus sons. And come, Mr. Hassan, come. And as I prayed with him and I blessed this young man, you know, when my brother was home, he took care of him. And I remember one day we couldn't get him up. This young man stood on the bed with his 2 feet so that he could hold my dad, my brother, to lift him off the bed. And he was there day and night, working and taking care of my brother. So again, God bless you.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
It's so much I can say about. I was thinking I would have to be. Since he embraced me, since I met him, he embraced me with tough love. He was the only person I know that actually would let you know. But I love you, because you'll cook a whole pot of food. Advice, delivery was harsh, it was real. Tell me about loyalty and be yourself.
Amen, 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 amen. The lives we live when we passed on, you know, people should be able to say, this is what was done. This is the life he touched. And he has another bonus son, and I'm going to quickly read it. You know, this is another young man in Trinidad. This is a young man who had some challenges, negative challenges, but there's something about my brother that he will really reach out to any young man who was struggling. And I'm going to read this quickly because we're running out of time. My dad was like my superhero. No one can take his place. Chuck was my biggest inspiration and a true hero to me. The strength he possessed wasn't flashy or in your face. He came into my life and showed me what a real father was like. Every day he will make sure that I ate and I drank. He would never one day make me miss no meal. He will always cover my food, make sure it's there until I got home from wherever I was. He was quiet, unassuming man who just got on with things, principles, and determination. Then he never wanted that life called badness for me. Oh yeah, and this, he was a little bad boy too. I listened, he will always make sure and buy brooms and bandanas for me to hustle and don't interfere with people's things. He also teach me how to do landscape. I will always remember the good times we had, Dad. It's hard to imagine life without you. I will hold on to the memories we share forever through, although you live forever, you were miles away. It's hard for you to leave. You always beg me to come out and meet you. I will always love you. Your memories will always be in my heart. And these are the legacies we want to leave behind. So come and tell us at this time for another, you know, we're moving on. Is Cass here? Miss Terry, is Cass?
I don't see.
Okay. Okay, so we're moving right ahead. We're going to have acknowledgement by Shirley Samuel.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Coming to New York will be a challenge for me because everyone, none of them, same Deryck and I did. I have to let everyone come in. I want to go. My visits will be different. But thank you. I just want to thank you to everyone for all the support I've given my family during this difficult time. We want to acknowledge prayers, calls, the visit. Every act of kindness that you all have given to give my family strength and inspiration during this day. May God continue to bless. And we have, family and family have received several cards, but because of time, I'll just read one to acknowledge. With deepest sympathy, true sorrow comes into our lives when those who we love must part. Love lives on forever in the warmest memories. The only cherished memories will fill us our hearts today as a special tribute to the beautiful life we have. The sympathy. And as I say, with my family, we all saw each other, seen each other today, and we continue to only see each other in these circumstances. Let today be a day that we want to try our best and make a commitment to be there for each other. As I went through this a little over a year ago with my mom, after today, you know, the love and the family's here. But maybe in a month, 2 months, 3 months, when you think it, please consider, it's not just today. Continue to be there for each other. We should not be only seeing each other to give a hug on a funeral day. Let's do better, please, family. I love you all unconditionally, but we need each other. And thank you. Reach out to family and the family in the coming days. Today is not it. Today is the first day of their grief and sorrow. So please, thank you.
Thank you, Cheryl. Amen. Amen. One thing I can say. During a crisis, you know, I have families, we stick together. And I remember we were all taking turns, spending the night with him, making sure that he's not alone. When in the hospital, there was always someone there visiting him. You know, so we thank God for them. There's another special person I really want to acknowledge. You know, Vanetta, his wife. They had some ups and downs in their marriage, like most marriage couples. But I tell you one thing. When my brother faced those last couple weeks, she came in and she supported and she helped and she cared for him. You know, we have to be able to put aside all differences. And I just want to honor you, and I just want to applaud you and commend you for what you have done during the last days of my brother's life. Can you put your hand together for that? Thank God. Okay, we're still moving on time. I'm going to give a few minutes for tributes. If you're going to do a tribute, I'm asking you, for 2 minutes, please. I'm gonna do 4 tributes. If you wanna do a tribute, pop up, 2 minutes. I'm gonna stop you after 2 minutes.
I'm off to speak. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, sir.
Deryck and I met at Amazon, but we started to sell food. I'm known as the Roti Man in Brooklyn, New York. Deryck is a very special guy. I didn't work on his shift, I worked on the shift, which is Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Every time you see Deryck, you can hear one word, "Oh, you shot on your soul so loud." The man and I have made food. I have a couple of times to go to the hospital and tell him, they would tell him, "You have to be there food, I got a roti, man, they can feed me." I love them.
Christians supposed to be eating that roti.
Yes, yes. No, well, you know what? He cheated. I didn't bring roti.
Okay.
But we were supposed to start this food business. I want Deryck to know, as of Monday gone, I finally broke through to start doing it because I had to go through filing paperwork that I'm mentally ill, which nothing is wrong with me, but for the government to pay me, I gotta be ill. Anyway, I love Deryck. Deryck, I was saddened when I heard he passed out because 2 days before, another co-worker asked me about him. I'm like, you know what? And I called this, and I called, the phone rang out.
Amen.
So then another co-worker is in the back, Nick Richard, he explained, let me know that Deryck passed out. I'm supposed to meet you too.
Okay.
I'm so busy, but I gotta run because I gotta go make real tea.
Okay. Thank you for coming. Thank you for coming. Next one, 2 minutes. Be popping this quickly. Should I get your song ready?
Thank you.
Tribute. Another cousin. No matter where we are, what's happening, always here.
Good morning, everyone. So my grandmother told me to come up here, which is Deryck's aunt. I just want to say that I love my cousin dearly. I'm going to miss him. When he passed, it's funny. The first thing I did was laugh because he was so funny. And his favorite words was, "Hey, I go beat anything. I is very child."
Yeah, yeah.
Or he would say, "Watch now," and then a joke would follow. So Deryck, I'm glad I didn't come to see the viewing because I want to remember him how I last saw him. Like Shola said, we all should try to be with each other, even when there's not a funeral. So again, thank you for everyone for coming out. I see my beautiful family. Oh, shucks, I just see two in the front. I didn't know it was here. And Deryck, I'm gonna miss you. I know you're an angel. I know that God has you, and to his children, you guys had a great father. Don't ever forget all the lessons that he taught all of us. He was love. Deryck was very, very loving, and I am gonna miss him.
Amen, thank you.
Thank you. I see one more. 2 minutes.
Well, morning to everyone, blessings on the family. There were children. And this is a sort of difficult time for me because this is when I lost my mom. But some words of inspiration to each and every one. Pray until things start changing. And then pray sometimes more. Even if things don't change, right away, keep praying. And don't stop. Believe and pray. Never lose your faith. Never stop being grateful to the one and only God that we know. Thank you very much.
Amen. Hallelujah. I just feel to take a praise break. God, we thank you. I thank you. I thank you. I thank you. I thank you. And this is my little nephew. Coming in from out of town, 2 minutes. 2 minutes too? Yes.
Good morning, everyone. I just want to say something on behalf of my aunt. Put a speaker closer to the mic for right, auntie.
Thank you. Thank you, Mara.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mara. Thank you. the obituary, it's my aunt, Auntie Monica Burton. You know, we lost both our parents. And my aunt has stepped up as, you know, a covering over us. She calls, she prays, she inquires, she follow up, you know, so we don't have a parent, so she adopted us as her children.
Good morning.
Morning.
Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a steadfast spirit within me. My name is Monica, as Bev says, and I thank God that I do not wait until a time like this to reach out. I don't care who calls me. I'm going to call you. I'm going to reach out because it's my duty. And fuck, it's such an important part in my life. I was given a ministry to go and feed the homeless in Trinidad. And Beverly, Pearline. Pearline had a two-bedroom house and it was packed. I would send the barrels down. And when you get there, there's no more space. But I said, I have to do my father's business. And Chuck came. And I said, Chuck, we have to cook because I have ministry that was given to me to feed the homeless. He said, no sweat, auntie. Got three big rocks. And he put the rocks in the backyard of Curly's. And he cooked tirelessly. We were able to feed 1,500 to 2,000 people a day. And this is me flying down there for 2 days. I take 2 days from work. I would fly down there, and Chuck would cook and cook. And Bob Vonnet, thank you, and Joan. All of them were there to help me pack these boxes, these cartons, the Chinese cartons with food to give to the homeless.
Amen.
And we did that for 5 years. The Lord has blessed me, and Chuck was my main man. He would cook, and he would stir, and he would cook, and he would have the line moving with them filling out those boxes. And I thank God that he was a part of that, because it made such a difference in my life to have had him do what he did. Right along. Deryck Chuck Badman. And in his final days, the Warrior Murray was born June 1st, 1966, in Port of Spain, Trinidad, to Veronica Samuel Murray and Donald Murray. Deryck attended Chinapoo Government School, Movant, Laventure, Junior Secondary and Malik Senior Comprehensive School in Trinidad. Deryck migrated to the United States with his family in 2011. He reunited with his mom and siblings. He worked at Amazon, where he was well known for his commitment, consistency in teamwork, and collaboration in the workplace. Deryck earned his nickname Flagman as a multi-talented entrepreneur who loved his birthplace and sold flags, t-shirts, trinkets, and other handcrafted items to promote Caribbean culture in the United States. He was passionate about educating and sharing Trinidad history to the community. He was also a chef, tell us about it, who sold, fed anyone who was hungry. He planted his garden to grow special spices for his delicious Ital dishes and drinks during the annual Caribbean Labor Day Festival. He was dedicated to his children, family, and everyone whom he embraced. He monitored and helped them. He was respected in the community and had a special place in his heart for elders by always lending a helping hand. His children describe him as a legend to the world, the biggest hustler, and more importantly, a man of God, who loved his children and a father to all. During the past 6 months of his life, he was called a warrior. He displayed a tenacious spirit to fight to live for his children. He taught his family and friends what it means to have a grit and determination as he fought for his life. His faith was strong in God, even in the midst of his challenges. He encouraged us to keep our faith alive. This is the legacy he left. 4 days before he passed away, he embraced us, all with hugs, telling us how much he loved us. Deryck, your life was a blessing. Your memory will forever be in my treasure. On October 25th, 2023, due to complications of cancer, Deryck made his entrance into heaven's jubilee. Deryck is survived by his wife, Vonette Belter Murray, children Alba, Abia, Akif, Leslie, Dan, and Hassan's siblings, Stephen, Beverly, Joan, Heather, Darren, Pearline, Jennifer, Winston, Merle, and Michael, brothers-in-law, Gath, Lester, Kurt, and Aquino as well, as sister-in-law, Mary Ann, and Rose. Also leaves behind 25 nieces and nephews, 39 great nieces and nephews, Uncle Eddie Samuel, aunts Teresa Matson, and Monica Burton, and a host of cousins and close friends, all left behind to mourn his passing. Deryck, your life was a blessing. Your memory will forever be treasured. I have to make a quick comment. I wouldn't say impressed, I was so moved that every time I talked to either one of the sisters, someone was there with him. We know the Lord is always with us, but he was never alone without a human sibling there. And I thank God for that, and may he continue to bless each and every one of you in a mighty, mighty way. We may be going through something now called grief, but it's a going through. The Lord will not let us stay there. That's a promise. And we all know that God is good all the time. And all the time, God is good. Even in the valley where we are now, God is still good.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. So we're going to do this song, The Goodness of God. This was my brother's anthem song.
There's one simple vision hack anyone can use to improve vision, so you can say goodbye to your optometrist for good. Did you know that vision impaired?
That's all right. They're going to play this song. You know? You know, you can sing along.
I love you, Lord, for your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hands. From the moment I wake up till I lay my head, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. Yeah.
Mr. Deryck Edwards. You know, I want to tell you a little bit about this song. I'm not going to be long. In his last days, we call him the warrior. We had a family app where we would share, you know, every progress, every struggle together. And when we named him the warrior, the last 6 months of his life, he fought. I thought we would have lost him on three occasions. But he will bounce right back up. I remember one time I'll take him out of the hospital, I was sitting. By this time he could not even use his legs, couldn't move. And I was still holding his hand by his bed. And he says, sis, I'm gonna show you, I'm gonna come up them steps. I'm gonna go to my doctor's appointment. I don't care what the doctors say. I know I am going to beat this cancer. And you know, we look at the physical aspect of it. And we know, you know, in our hearts, you know what? This guy's gonna die. He needs to accept the fact that he is going to die. But he refused to believe that he was going to die. And he hold on to his faith. And one thing I can tell you, we all learn from my brother, Deryck Truck Flagman Murray. He held on to his faith. And I want to say that's the legacy he left with me. Because it doesn't matter what his physical eye saw. It doesn't matter what his leg, his body, what. He held on to his faith that God is in control of his life. And I can testify to the fact today. I say it is bittersweet. You know, bitter because we lost him. Sweet because he came to know the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And as I look around in this room, it's all that matters. It's all that matters. Your soul. Your soul. That is just the building that he's living in. But it's his soul that matters. If you don't know the Lord, my brother taught us a lesson, and I hope it impacted all my family members. That, at the end of it all, is only Christ that matters.
Amen.
And when he accepted that, he was saying, oh, sis, I'm tired.
Amen.
I'm tired.
Amen.
And I believe he held on for 6 months of suffering. When I tell you suffering, I mean suffering at the point where we would pray and cry and say, God, if the transition is going to take place, take it, God, please. I prayed God, and he was like, can't say taking me. You know, but God healed him. God healed him. God healed him. God bless you again. I thank you. Thank you for all the families and friends who come out to talk. And at this time, I'm going to call for Pastor Gloria Edwards. My bishop is not here today. Bishop Arthur Hugh Nelson, you know, who is the senior pastor of my church, EUMC. And I'm so grateful to have all my church family members. Just stand for 1 minute. Church, just stand for a few. All for my church. Thank you so much for your support, your love, your care. My God, I am loved by these people. And because they love me, they love my family too. God bless you. Pastor Gloria.
Amen. Praise the Lord, everybody.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We lift up the name of the Lord today. We honor him for his faithfulness. I thank God this morning that I'm able to be here. And yes, EUMC love you all. Even of those we do not know, we love you based on the fact of your sister. And so on behalf of Bishop Dr. RCU Nelson, First Lady Nelson, just want to offer our condolences. And of course, Bishop Nelson traveled to Brazil, I believe came home last night, was on his way to another mission, and that's why they're not here this morning. Because I want to let you know that our dear chaplain Deaconess Beverly Adams, plays an integral part in our church, and we want to be here to celebrate with her. And again, all of EUMC, please stand up at this time. All of Ebenezer Urban Ministry Center, yes, thank God. Amen. Amen. Amen.
God, we bless God, we lift up God. We also have with us Pastor Patrick Vernon. We also have with us Reverend Logan, and we give God thanks for the family. I must say to you that, yes, Chuck, Flagman, right, Deryck, Chuck, Flagman, is gone to be with the Lord. The Lord embraced him, and so he's there in his great mansion that God has prepared for him. Because God told him, I go away, but I'll come back and I will receive you unto myself. That where I am, there he will be also. And today we thank God that he's resting in the arms of Father Abraham. You know, when we were little kids, my grandmother used to, Father Abraham, and many sons of Father Abraham, I am one of them, and so are you. So let's just praise the Lord right and left. All right now. Okay. Amen. Amen. When I was first taking my driver's license, the driver that was in the car with me, he said, make a left turn and I need a right turn. So that's the reason why when you say right foot, left foot, I will always remember that I made a mistake right there. So I don't want to make a mistake. You say right foot and I give you left foot. Bless the Lord. And so today we are here again to celebrate a wonderful man, a man that has left indelible imprint in the lives not only of his family, but others. So we lift him up this morning. God, we give you praise, we give you honor, God, and we give you glory. We glorify your name, God, for who you are. We thank you, oh God, for your spirit. We thank you, God, Lord, that you have allowed your son the moment to be in your presence, oh God. And we thank you, Lord God, for the indelible imprint that he has made on planet Earth. And so, God, we lift you up and we praise you. And so, God, we realize, oh God, this is the time of mourning for the lives of the children and the entire family. But God, we realize that one day their mourning will come into joy. We realize, God, that one day, God, Lord, they will sit back and they will experience all the memories, oh Almighty God, with, oh God, your loved ones. So we give you praise and honor, and we thank you in Jesus' precious name. Amen and amen. And I saw a great white throne, and him who sat on it, earth and sky fled from his presence, and there was no place for them. And I saw the dead, great and small, standing before the throne, and books were opened. Another book was opened, which is the book of life. The dead were judged according to what they had done, as recorded in the books. The sea gave up the dead that were in it, and death and Hades gave up the dead that were there in them. And each person was judged according to what he has done. Then death and Hades were thrown into the lake of fire. The lake of fire is the second death. If anyone's name was not found written in the book of life, he was thrown into the lake of fire. This morning, I just want to speak to you on the teacher for death. Teachers play an important part in the human experience. All persons in one way or another, for better or worse, are affected by the teachers in their lives. They impact our lives from the cradle to the grave. There is one teacher that we do not like to listen to, but this teacher raises our awareness about one's life, most important mysteries and realities. The teacher calling card is marked death. It is said that a mediocre teacher tells, the good teacher explains, the superior teacher demonstrates, the great teacher inspires. The death of a loved one becomes a teachable moment, the reality of death. First, we are reminded of the reality of death. Our text speaks briefly but clearly. Everyone is going to die. Some people refuse to think about death. Some are nonchalant about it. Others live in fear of it. And some deal with it through the eyes of a Christian. It comes down every highway, across every sky. Saints and sinners, rich and poor experiences. It is no respecter of persons. So hear me today. And what is the reason for death? The logical question is, why does death exist? What is the reason of death? The scripture tells us that death entered the planet Earth when the first man and woman rebelled in disobedience to God's clear commands. He had instructed Adam and Eve, "You must not eat from the tree of knowledge of good and evil, for when you eat of it, you will surely die." Man did what God forbade. Death, an intruder, an alien to God's desire for mankind, came. Since Adam represented the human race, all humanity inherited his tragic death. And what they inherit? The tragic death of genes. When you consider death, you must look at the realm of death. The separation of the soul from the body is for more than physical. It is also spiritual. An alienation of the spirit from God, and it's eternal. Physical death awaits every human. Physical death awaits every human. But because Jesus overcame death, we live in expectant hope. This world is not our home. This world is not our home. I would love to hear an amen in that.
Amen.
Death makes us absent from the body, but it also ushers up into the presence of the Lord. Paul stated it this way, "For me to live is Christ, and to die is gain." To live as Christ is to conquer death as he did. What Jesus did to death enables us to do the same thing. We are more. I said we are more than conquerors. We are more than conquerors to them that love the Lord. There is an eternal death that is awaiting us outside of grace, the forgiveness of Jesus Christ. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life. It is a terrible payday, but a very real one. Every one of us will die and must die. Hallelujah to Jesus. I want to let you know of a story of two little boys was running down the road, and they saw a beehive, and one of the child went to play with the beehive. The bee came out and stung him, and after the bee stung him, he started to cry, and he cried, and he cried, and he cried, and so as he cried, the other little boy started to cry, but the bee started to run towards the other one. And that one cried even more, because he know that if the bee stung his brother, the same thing going to be for him. But one thing he did not know, and I don't know if you know that too, a bee only have one sting, and once that sting is done, he can't. So the wages of sin is death, but the gift of life is eternal. Oh death, where is thy sting? Oh grave, where is thy victory? So you see, death comes once. It's not gonna say to you, "I'll come back and meet you again." Not gonna tell you once the death comes, that's it. That's it for me, you, and everybody. We gonna die. We all gonna die. Facing these reality, you have to be ready. It's a crucial for every person to make the proper plans for this journey. The more significant the journey, the more thorough our preparation will be. So if you are here today and you're not thinking about making your call and
be a readiness for death. The psalmist underscored it when he wrote, teach us to number our days aright, that we may gain a heart of wisdom. How can we do it? First, we can think about death honestly, contemplate on the reality that we will not always be in this world. Death teaches us to make time count. There is a time for everything and a season for every activity under heaven. Some wrote it this way: so valiant is time that God gives only a moment in it at once, and he gives that moment but once in eternity. Teach us, Lord, to number our days. Death teaches us about eternal value, what is important in life, not cars and house and land and businesses. When we give our life to God, hallelujah, it's complete. I am not preaching to Deryck anymore. Deryck has accepted the Lord Jesus Christ. He's in the mansion prepared for him. I'm talking to you, and I'm talking to me, that I must accept him, live for him, in spirit and in truth. Walk holy and righteousness before our Lord, our loving God, who has able and has kept us all these years. So we bless God even right now. Hallelujah. 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 Death teaches us about eternal values, and say what is important in life. Death instructs us about the significance of relationship. Never take for granted a spouse, a child, cherished friends, a colleague, family, parents, grandparents. Are at the heart of who we are. Cherish every shared experience, the memories of special occasion. Make new memories, write notes of love and gratitude. Give someone you love something you value and keep it on going. Love each other. Love each other. Be together. Be together. You don't have to wait until a funeral to be together. This is a big family. Love each other and care for each other. Auntie said the same thing when she got up here. She wants everybody to come together, everybody to love each other, no matter what the situation may be. You may not all agree on everything, but your family, you have the same DNA. Love each other. 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 Hallelujah. Do not be afraid to say, I love you. Listen to what a bereaved husband said. He said, what I miss about my wife who is gone. Before I leave to work, every morning as I pick up my bag, she would say, honey, I love you, and give me a kiss. That's what he said most of all. So when you can kiss your loved one, kiss your loved one. When you can hug your loved one, love your loved one. Keep short accounts. Hear me. Keep short accounts with disagreement and anger. Keep short accounts with disagreement and anger. Be quick to say, I'm sorry and forgive me. Mend broken fences. Seek to live in your relationship so that regret will not be your companion in years ahead. Should I say that again to you? Keep short accounts with disagreements and anger. Be quick to say, I'm sorry and forgive me. Mend broken fences. Seek to live in your relationship so that regret will not be your companion in years again.
You tell it,
Emma. Death. Death underscores the most important preparation of all, preparing to go into the eternity to face God. The Old Testament writer Amos said it in one sentence: prepare to meet your Lord.
Amen.
Prepare to meet your Lord. Prepare to meet your Lord. Our New Testament text repeated after this.
Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. The wages of sin is death, but here is the great and good news. The gift of God is eternal life through Christ Jesus, our Lord. There is no better time than right now to settle your eternal destiny and to receive Jesus Christ as your personal Savior and Lord. It is simple. Everyone who calls in the name of the Lord will be saved. Hallelujah to Jesus. We thank you, Lord. We give you praise. We honor you. We honor you. We honor you, God. Hallelujah. We honor you. Thank you. Thank you for a moment. And this is, like I would say, a praise break to God. Hallelujah. I don't know if you were born saved, but I was not born saved. And I want to tell you, hallelujah to Jesus. One day, my God, I have a grandmother. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. People say, why do you talk about your grandmother? My husband said, anything you have become, my God, is because of your grandmother. You implicate your grandmother. Everything. I have a grandmother who said she could hardly read, but she would say to me, I'm not going to tell you my pet name. She would say to me, get the Bible, and I get the Bible. She couldn't read, but she knew the word. And she would say, read for me, read for me. And I would go and I would read for my grandmother. And I read, and she said, hallelujah to Jesus. She said, let me tell you, she used to say, I don't want to search heaven for you. You see, I was the only child in the house, and she dedicated her life to me. And so she said, I don't want to be searching heaven. And I know that sometimes I don't do the things that I was supposed to do back then. But thanks be to God, God gave me a chance. And God will give you a second chance too. God has given Chuck another chance. Slapman got another chance. So even if you sit here and said he was a drunk, he used to drink and he used to smoke and he loved women and all of those things, he had a time that he came to God. He had a time when he said, Father, Father, forgive me. Father, forgive me. And his heavenly Father forgave him for all the sins. So if you are sitting down here and said, look at how they are polishing up his life. Oh no! When he said yes, Lord, to your will and everything to your way, oh God, God, wipe away. Everything that he had done in his life was not suiting before God. So today, as I come before you, I want to let you know it is now. It is now for you. For those who, let me tell you this. Death teaches us the final result of life choices. For all whose faith is in Jesus Christ, I could say to you that you, as an individual, if you say yes, Lord, to your will and to your way, and you accept him, and tomorrow you decide that I don't want this, I don't want this. What God say? You are my child.
Amen.
I will receive you back.
Amen.
Just say, sorry, Lord. Just sorry. Just sorry. And I'm running because I'm closing. That for all whose faith is in Jesus Christ, death comes. But here, today, you will be with me, he said, to the thief on the cross. Today you will be with me in paradise. This was his promise to the dying thief. It is the same Savior who gives the same promise to all of us who are here today. For those who refuse this choice is a disastrous one. John writes it in Revelation. Then I saw a great white throne, and him who seated on it. Earth and sky fled from his presence, and there was no place for them. And I saw the dead, great and small, standing before the throne, and a book was opened, which is a book of life. If
anyone's name was not found written in the book of life. He was thrown. I said he was thrown. He was thrown. He was thrown into the lake of fire. And so today as I come, I want you to know that death is a destroyer, but Jesus Christ is the great rearranger. Life starts out with the union of two invisible cells. They multiply in 9 months. A miracle and a human body is formed. Once outside the womb, that body continues to change and rearrange. Hallelujah. Itself from a baby to a child, to a youth, to an adult, to a senior adult, to death. Listen to me, to death, this body is, and after death, it starts to decay. So we say dust to dust, but Jesus came to destroy death. Death becomes not the beginning of the end, but the end of the beginning. So listen to me today. The words of 2 Corinthians, now we know that if this earthly tent we live in is destroyed, we have a building from God, an eternal house in heaven, not built by human hands. That means at least three things. One, our building, our body is one that we possess right now. Number two, our new building will be better than the one we have. Chuck body that he had down here in earth is not as good as the body that is awaiting him in heaven. Hallelujah. It will be a body that is going to be like Jesus. Scripture promise, but we know that when he appears, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. My God, my God, my God. So this morning, hallelujah, we are looking forward to that great day. That great day when Jesus Christ will call us home. Hallelujah to God. The dead will rise first. And those who are alive and remain, hallelujah to Jesus, will be caught up.
Amen. Yes.
I said we'll be caught up in the here to meet him. So this morning, I say to you, are you ready? Are you ready to meet your Lord and your Savior, Jesus Christ? Are you ready? Are you ready to meet your Savior, Jesus Christ? Did you make your call and election sure? Hallelujah. If Jesus could come today and take you home to be with him, are you ready? Are you ready? It is stated all that Chuck did in life. It is stated here. But thank you, God. God rescued him.
Amen.
He prepared himself for death.
Yes.
Even if it's 1 second before death, he made it home.
That's right.
Even
That's right.
if it was just a second.
That's right. He did it. He did it.
He made it home.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Are you prepared to meet your Savior today? This is the question I would like to ask the family as I close. Are you prepared to meet your Savior? Are you prepared? If you are not prepared, this is the moment. This is the moment. Just say, pray for me. Pray for me. Just say, pray for me. Pray for me.
Yeah.
I'm not asking you to step out of your seat. I'm asking you to just lend your hand up. Just put your hand up. Say, pray for me. I am not ready. Pray for me. Come on, I see two hands. Come on, I see two hands. I see two hands. I see a third. I see a fourth hand. I see a fifth hand. I see a fifth hand. I see a sixth hand. I see a sixth hand. Pray for me. Praise be to God. Praise be to God. Praise be to God. And now, Pastor Vernon is going to pray for the hands that raise, saying that I do not know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, and I want to know him, because if I die today, I don't know where I'm going. I would love to sing the song, I know where I'm going. Joy bells are ringing and happy children are singing. I know where I am going. I
alone. But if you don't know where you're going, you can't sing that song and go through it before the Lord. Let us pray for them.
Father, those who raised their hands, could you just repeat after me? Father, I believe your word. You said, believe in me and thou shalt be saved. And if I confess all my sins, you will forgive me. So today, Lord, I give you my life. Lord, I give you my all. And thank you for saving me. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
That's all it takes. That's all it takes. That's it.
Hallelujah. Because I live, you shall live also. And so, God bless you today. God bless those who gave their hearts to the Lord. God bless you that all is days like Pastor Vernon said. God bless you. And so, family could be seated, and everyone else please stand as we do the benediction. Well, before the benediction, let's call and Chaplain Whitaker. Chaplain Whitaker, please come to do the prayer of comfort.
This verse in Psalms reads, precious the sight of the Lord, yet saints. I used to wonder why, and it came to me when Father see his children does so proud. Same way, our Heavenly Father is pleased with what his Son Jesus. So today, take comfort. Your loved one, precious, sight of God, is with you. Our God and our Father, precious name of your Son Jesus Christ, we must see this morning. Father God, we are gathered together in this solemn prayer. Passing of one, loved one, friend, brother. Father God, I pray, oh God, that you would comfort, oh God, your children. Said, let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God. Believe in God. Pray, Father God, that they would take comfort, knowing, oh God, of where their loved one is at. Father God, that they can take, oh Father, faith from people. Turn dear lights over, but they know you not yet. And accept Jesus Christ. Thank you.
And so, raise your right hand with me. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May his face radiate with joy because of you. May he lift the light of his countenance upon you, and may he give you his peace. Both now and forevermore. God bless you all. God bless you. And thank you for this opportunity. I know some of you may want to do a final viewing. We are running on time. We could do this, but it has to be very brief. Please just do the viewing and just step right out. Where's the funeral director? Where's the funeral director? Yes, please, just briefly. Mm-hmm.
please go immediately to your vehicle. If you're going to the cemetery, you must be out here very quickly.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, if you go into the cemetery, you need to exit the chapel.